Good morning and welcome to
Eagle's Nest Live for your AHS Morning News. Hello, I'm Kinsey.
And I'm Allie Page, and we are here to provide you with the news for today, Friday, January 13th.
Eagle Refuel will not be available today. Again, no Eagle Refuel between MP and second period today.
Apollo tennis teams will have open courts on Saturday, January 14th from 11:30 to 1 p.m. at center court on the indoor courts. The cost is $5 per person. Please note the time change.
Welcome to the first Friday the 13th of 2017.
Here's some superstitions you may not know.
Oh no, it's Black Cat Friday the 13th!
Don't get your hair cut on Friday the 13th because one of your family members could die.
On Friday the 13th, Kevin doesn't walk under ladders, he slides under them.
Call out some more acceptances of seniors. We've got a lot, and we got our bell here. We're ready to go. Summer Hillard, KWC, Kelsey Drunnell, University of Kentucky, Adam Hertzler, Murray State, and University of Kentucky. Woo! Sydney Blair, WKU Brescia, and USI. And Neil Towery, Transy. Man, that's a big one. U of L, UK, and Murray. We're excited. We are moving into scholarship season. Bring in your scholarship letters. Bring them in. MP today, two announcements on that. Juniors, you're in the auditorium. Seniors, you're in the small gym. Miss Dane.
Mr. Cameron, I sensed a little bit of doubt in the auditorium the other day when we talked about the total for senior scholarship. Last year's class of 2016, they were offered over $7 million in scholarship money. We challenged the current class of 2017 seniors to match that or beat it. I sensed a little bit of doubt. $7 million, that sounds like a lot. How in the world can we get up to $7 million? What does that look like? We're asking seniors to bring in copies of their scholarship award letters to guidance so we can get to that total. How in the world do we get to a number like $7 million?
Writing. Get on the guidance website. There was like $200,000 of scholarships put on in the last week and a half. That's no joke. There's literally $200,000 on there. Thank you. Have a good day.
Thank you.
That's right, guys. It's DV weekend here at Apollo. Woo! If you do not have a team yet, that's fine. Show up Sunday. If you haven't turned in your registration forms or fees, come on out. We'll find you a team. We'll find you a spot. Come out for some food, friends, and games, and come help make a difference for the kids.
Sorry about that. In other news, also the Nate's Blue. Tonight, at the game tonight, the theme is Hollywood theme. So if you're planning on going to homecoming, just show up in your dresses and nice clothes. And if you aren't planning to show up to homecoming, then just wear all black and the theme for paparazzi for Hollywood. All right, everybody, show out tonight versus Catholic. We're going to get that dub again.
Go Eagles!
Go Eagles!
Students attending the homecoming dance tonight should make note of the following. The dance will be held in the little gym, not in the commons area. Entrance to the dance will be through the set of doors closest to the band room. You will not be able to enter through the gym lobby. The Spanish National Honor Society will be sponsoring a coat and bag check. The cost will be $1 per person.
Next ACT college entrance test will be Saturday, February 11th. The deadline to register online at www.actstudent.org is today. Students who are interested in getting registered for the February ACT test and need some help with the process, please stop by the guidance office. And for those of you who are interested in off-campus programs next school year, are encouraged to take the February ACT if you have never taken it.
Hello, good morning. Good morning, Apollo High School. Quick announcement about track and field for both boys and girls. Track practice has started. We got fully underway this week with our sprinters. I want to make something a couple things really clear, especially for our young people who are new to Apollo. It's still open. Come join us whenever you can. We have sprinters working. We have distance runners working. We're going to have throwers working next week. All you need is a sports physical, okay? No experience necessary. Just get a sports physical. So if you're sitting at home thinking when's track practice started, we're going. We're going every day after school, 3:30 to 5. You can stop by room 318 if you have any questions whatsoever. Next week during Mission Possible time or maybe before school, we're going to try to have a very brief informative meeting if you just want to come out and ask some questions. But long story short, if this is something that you've been thinking about doing, come out and give it a shot. If you try it for a week and it's just not your thing, no big deal. But anyway, that's about it. Come see me in 318 if you have any questions, and have a great day, Apollo.
Edition of Eagle Nation Sports. I'm Dalton.
And I'm Sydney.
Last Friday, the boys' varsity basketball team faced off with rival Davis County, pulling off another victory over DC with a score of 52-51.
They're playing basketball
All around the world. To the beach, y'all.
They're playing basketball
All around the world. Y'all know this is so, so.
Apollo bowling teams traveled to the PRP Invitational in Louisville Saturday, and both the boys and girls team finished in third place.
The Apollo swimmers returned to competition after Christmas by making a splash into the 2017 City County Championship on Saturday. The boys swam their way into the second place finish, their best in many years. Congratulations, boys.
Monday night, the Apollo bowling team faced Davis County in their second meeting this season and came away with a 5-2 win.
On Tuesday, the Apollo swimmers were back in the water to take on Muhlenberg County in a dual meet. The girls put up a good fight but came up short in the end, while the boys remained undefeated.
The Eagles basketball team defeated Butler County Tuesday night 71-30. Congratulations, Eagles.
That's it for this week's edition of Eagle Nation Sports.
On today's lunch menu in the Mama's Kitchen and Global Fairline, we will be having pizza, chicken enchilada, refried beans, rice, salsa, and cookie. In the sandwich line, a choice of cheeseburger, chicken, grilled chicken, or peanut butter and jelly, fries, veggies and dip, Caesar salad, fruit choice, and cookie. In the sub and salad line, chef salad or sub, veggies and dip, fruit choice, and ice cream.
We'd like to wish the activities good luck as they participate in events this evening. The band as they compete in the All-District Honor Band today in Madisonville. The boys and girls varsity basketball teams as they host Owensboro Catholic this evening with the girls playing at 5:30 and the boys at 7. And the wrestling team as they compete in the regional sectionals at Owensboro High School tomorrow. Thank you and have a great weekend.
Good morning, Eagles. A couple of quick announcements here on this Friday, January 13th. Coach Barker, the yogurt bar is still open in the teacher's lounge. Secondly, about the game tonight, I want to remind everyone to be classy and remember not to stoop to the level of our opponents in the jeering and taunting. Be positive and pro Apollo. As far as birthdays go, we have several to get through this long weekend. Kaylin Carper celebrating a birthday today. Noah Collings, Eric Ferris, Caleb Locker, Mercedes Pierce, tomorrow, Emily Johnson, Dakota Proctor, Maria Tomas, Valerie Gillum, Jade Phipps Gibson on the 15th, Yanyo Ton on the 15th, and then Monday, Martin Luther King Day. So Lynn Lahr, Pa Payne, Molly Stats, and Kenzie Toms. Let's everyone make it a great day.
Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.